in horizontal direction na body moving on horizontal plane on the surface of the ground. Clear? No? So for uniform motion, what was the equation we studied? Chappal twarga. For uniform motion, displacement is equals to velocity into time. This is the only equation. No? So what is meant by uniform motion? Uniform motion means? Uniform motion means?
Constant.
What is constant? Velocity is a constant. Uniform motion means velocity is a constant. If velocity is a constant, this is the only equation which we have. Clear? Then we studied about accelerated motion or non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion means what?
Velocity
is not a constant. Velocity of the body is continuously changing. Clear? No? And what about acceleration? Acceleration is a constant. Or you can say acceleration is not zero. Okay. What is meant by acceleration is not zero? Acceleration is not zero means acceleration is present. Adhe kada dani meaning. Okay. If acceleration is not zero, it means acceleration is present. Velocity is not a constant, but acceleration is a constant. Then this type of motion we call it as non-uniform motion. So in this one, how many equations we have? Four equations. What are the four equations? V is equals to u plus at is the first equation. So s is equals to ut plus half at square is the second equation. So v square minus u square is equals to 2as. This is the third equation. So sn is equals to Sn is equals to u plus a into n minus 1 by 2. This is the fourth equation. Clear number? So these are the equations which we have studied when body is moving on a horizontal surface. Horizontal means which is making an angle of zero with respect to ground. Clear number? Now we are studying about vertical motion. What is meant by vertical motion? Up and down motion is called as vertical motion. Are you able to understand? No? So if I take a stone and if I drop it from top of a tower, then body is coming downwards, no? So it is also vertical motion. Similarly, if I take a stone and if I throw it upwards, then also it is a vertical motion. Are you able to understand? So in this vertical motion also, again motion I can divide into two types, no? Clear, no? So one is uniformly vertical motion and non-uniform vertical motion. So uniform vertical motion means what? Uniform vertical motion means? Velocity is a constant, body is coming down with the same velocity. Clear now? Then that kind of motion we can call it as uniform vertical motion. Similarly, if body is coming downwards with an acceleration. So generally earth is pulling the body, no? If earth pulls the body, it means earth is applying some force, no? Force is equal to mass into acceleration, no? It means earth is making that body to accelerate. Earth is making that body to increase its velocity. Are you able to understand? That kind of motion, what I call it as? I call it as non-uniform motion, or you can call it as an accelerated motion. And these are the equations which we can use. Are you able to understand? So then what is the difference between horizontal motion and vertical motion that we are going to discuss now? Are you able to understand? So therefore, Sima, in studying vertical motion, we have certain sign conventions. Conventions are there in studying vertical motion. Okay, ma? So you have to solve the problem only according to these sign conventions only. Okay, if you don't solve them with the help of sign conventions, then also you can do the problems, but it will take a lot of effort and a lot of confusion will be there. Are you able to understand, ma? So with the sign conventions, we will not have any confusion. So let us try to understand. So first sign convention is the position from which, the position from which body is thrown, is taken as reference. Are you able to understand? No? So from wherever we are throwing the body, that point we are taking as the reference. Is it clear, ma? So second one. Okay, if velocity of body is directed above the reference, then such velocity is taken positive. Clear, ma? And you can write and vice versa. And vice versa. Clear, ma? So third one, okay? If displacement is above the reference, clear, ma? Such displacement is taken positive and vice versa. Clear, ma? So these are the three sign conventions which we have to use in the case of vertical motion. Are you able to understand, ma? Make a note. Completed? Okay. Same. So these are the three sign conventions which you should always follow while studying which kind of motion? Vertical motion. Are you able to understand, ma? See. So consider this is a tower. Height of the tower, let it be h. Are you able to understand? So for example, if you take one body here and you are throwing the body in upward direction, you are taking one more body and you are throwing this one in downwards direction. Are you able to understand? So body number one and body number two, both of them, they are thrown from this position, no ma? Clear, no? So therefore, what is my rule number one here? The position from which body is thrown is taken as the reference. Clear? It means for first body as well as second body, this line will become the reference. So we are throwing from this position only, no? So that becomes our reference. Are you able to understand? So this is our reference. Okay? So reference for first body also, reference for second body also, because both of them, they are thrown from the same position. Okay. So see the next point which we are writing here. The velocity of the body is directed above the reference, then such velocity is taken positive and vice versa. So this body, we are throwing this one above the reference. We are throwing this one above the reference. So such velocity should be taken positive. Okay, ma? So the velocity which is thrown above the reference, such velocity should be taken positive. Now if you take velocity of this one, it is directed below the reference, no ma? So such velocity I should take negative. Velocity of this body is negative. Are you able to understand, ma? So you are supposed to take a reference as our basic comparison point. Clear? So from there only we will do every calculation. Okay? So if velocity is above the reference, such velocity is positive. If velocity is below the reference, such velocity is negative. Okay, ma? Second point. So what is the third point here? The third point is, if displacement is above the reference, then such a displacement is taken positive and vice versa. It means that, for example, consider this is the top of the tower from which I am throwing the body. Clear, Nama? So I have thrown the body from here. So this body traveled like this and finally reached this position. Okay, Ma? After some time, body reached this position. Now body has reached how much distance, and whether that distance is positive or negative, how can you find out? You have to take the reference. What is the reference here? So body is thrown from here, no ma? So this becomes my reference. Are you able to understand? And body is present above the reference or below the reference? Above the reference. So such a displacement should be taken positive. Yes means a displacement, no ma? Such a displacement we should take positive. Are you able to understand? Okay. Similarly, when the same body, when it traveled like this, and let us consider it has reached up to here. Okay, ma? So this is the second position, no? So this becomes my first position, let it be second position. Are you able to understand? Now can you say what is the displacement of the body? Negative. Ekkada nunchi theesukovali displacement? From reference. So shall I take this total distance or shall I take only this much distance? Reference is fine, antavarku baane undi. My question is, we are throwing the body in upwards direction, no ma? So body first of all reaches up to maximum height, then it starts returning backwards, no? Ante kada? Stone, if you throw the stone upwards, పైకి వెళ్తుంది కదా ఫస్ట్. ఫస్ట్ ఇట్ విల్ రీచ్ టు ద మ్యాక్సిమం హైట్, దెన్ ఇట్ స్టార్ట్స్ రిటర్నింగ్ బ్యాక్. ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ మా? సో దేర్ ఫోర్ బాడీ హ్యాస్ రీచ్డ్ అప్ టు హియర్, ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రిటర్నింగ్ బ్యాక్. నౌ ద క్వశ్చన్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ మై డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్? డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ షల్ ఐ టేక్ దిస్ టోటల్ లెంత్ యాజ్ మై డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ రెఫరెన్స్? ఓకే, ఇట్ మీన్స్ దిస్ బికమ్స్ మై డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్. అంతే కదా. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ద హైట్ రీచ్డ్ బై ద బాడీ, దట్ ఐఎమ్ నాట్ కన్సర్న్డ్ అబౌట్. ఐఎమ్ డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ మీన్స్ వాట్? షార్టెస్ట్ డిస్టెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ఫస్ట్ పాయింట్ అండ్ సెకండ్ పాయింట్, స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ డిస్టెన్స్. క్లియర్ నమ్మ? స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ డిస్టెన్స్ మీన్స్ దిస్ ఈస్ ద స్టార్టింగ్ పాయింట్, దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఎండింగ్ పాయింట్, ఓన్లీ దిస్ డిస్టెన్స్ వీఆర్ సపోజ్ టు టేక్. ఓకే, వీఆర్ నాట్ కన్సర్న్డ్ అబౌట్ ద డిస్టెన్స్, హౌ మచ్ హైట్ ఈస్ హ్యాస్ రీచన్, దట్ ఐఎమ్ నాట్ కన్సర్న్డ్ అబౌట్. క్లియర్? బికాస్ వీఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ డిస్టెన్స్. వీఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ వెలాసిటీ, వీఆర్ నాట్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ స్పీడ్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్? ఓకే. సో దేర్ ఫోర్ ఫ్రమ్ ద రెఫరెన్స్ బాడీ ఫైనలీ హ్యాస్ కమ్ డౌన్వర్డ్స్ నమ్మ. సో సచ్ డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ షుడ్ బి టేకన్ నెగటివ్. సో ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అబౌవ్ ద రెఫరెన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ పాజిటివ్, బట్ హియర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ బిలో ద రెఫరెన్స్ నో, సో సచ్ డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ షుడ్ బి టేకన్ నెగటివ్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్? సో దిస్ ఈస్ అవర్ రూల్ నంబర్ 3 ఫర్ వర్టికల్ మోషన్. అండ్ వన్ మోర్ రూల్ ఈస్ దట్ యాక్సిలరేషన్ డ్యూ టు గ్రావిటీ, యాక్సిలరేషన్ డ్యూ టు గ్రావిటీ should be always taken, acceleration due to gravity should be always taken negative. Okay ma? So earth is pulling these bodies, no ma? Earth is pulling these bodies. So how can I write here? I can write for example, this is ground. Okay ma? This is ground and here there is a body of mass m. Are you able to understand? So this body is pulled by ground, namma. What is the force with which earth is pulling this body? It is pulling with a force of mg. Weight is nothing but a force, namma. Weight of the body is nothing but what? Weight is nothing but the force with which earth is pulling that body. That is nothing but weight of a body. So weight formula? mg. And this is the only force which is acting on this body, namma. So this force becomes net force. Net force formula according to Newton's second law? Mass into acceleration. Net force is mg. Clear namma? So A and A, if they can cancel, then A is equal to G. Clear now? So what is the acceleration which is produced by earth? Earth is producing an acceleration of G. And that symbol of G should be always taken negative. So therefore, I will write A is always equal to minus G. So these are the four sign conventions which we have to use in the case of vertically thrown bodies or vertically released bodies. Are you able to understand? Come on, make a note up to here, then we will do some sigma. So therefore, let us do this calculation. Here I can take t common, then it is t minus 10. And here I can take 8 common, then again it is t minus 10 is equals to 0. So t plus 8, t minus 10 is equal to 0. Clear ma? So two possibilities are there, Nama. One is t can be minus 8, t can be plus 10. టైమ్ ఈజ్ నెవర్ నెగటివ్. నెగటివ్ టైమ్ అనేది ఇంతవరకు లేదు మనం. ఓకేమా? టైమ్ ఈజ్ ఆల్వేస్ పాజిటివ్ ఉంటుంది. సో మై ఆన్సర్ ఈస్ 10 seconds. అండర్స్టూడ్ నో? సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ విచ్ కండిషన్? వెన్ ఐఎమ్ థ్రోయింగ్ ద బాడీ ఇన్ అప్వర్డ్స్ డైరెక్షన్ అండ్ బాడీ ఈస్ రీచింగ్ టు ద గ్రౌండ్. ఓకేమా? సో దిస్ ఈజ్ మై రెఫరెన్స్ పొజిషన్. బాడీ ఫైనలీ హ్యాస్ రీచ్డ్ నెగటివ్ హైట్ నో. సో మైనస్ 400 ఐ గాట్ ద ఆన్సర్. నౌ కెన్ యూ డూ ద క్యాల్కులేషన్ వెన్ బాడీ ఈస్ థ్రోన్ డౌన్వర్డ్స్? ఓకే, కమ్ అండ్ డూ ద క్యాల్కులేషన్. సీ వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఆన్సర్ యూ విల్ గెట్. టెన్నే వచ్చిందా మళ్ళీ? దెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రాంగ్. ఎయిట్ యూ గాట్ మేబీ. So minus 400, minus 10t, minus 5t square. Clear now? So 5t square plus 10t minus 400 is equal to 0. So if I divide by 5 again, then t square plus 2t minus 8t is equal to 0. Clear now? So minus 80 t square I can divide into two parts. Okay? So one is minus 80 no ma? So 10t minus 8t. Clear? So therefore, so t square plus 10t minus 80 minus 80 is equal to 0. Clear no ma? T plus 10 minus 8, if I take comma, then it is t plus 10 is equal to 0. So t minus 8, t plus 10 is equal to 0. So t is equal to 8 comma minus 10. Minus 10 is not possible, so t is equal to 8 second. Clear now? So now can you say what is the difference between previous condition and this condition? Ma? In previous condition, we had thrown the body upwards. No? Clear now? Ma? So therefore that velocity we had taken positive in the previous condition. But in this condition, body is thrown downwards, no? It means it is below the reference. Velocity is directed below the reference. So such velocity should be taken negative. That is the only difference. In the previous condition, we have taken velocity positive, no? Now we are taking velocity negative because it is thrown below the reference. Clear, no? Then this calculation, everything you know, that is how we have done this calculation. Fine? So when body was thrown upwards, it has taken 10 seconds to reach the ground. But when it is thrown downwards, then it has taken only 8 seconds to reach the ground. Fine? That's it. Yes. See, ma'am. So from top and bottom of a tower, two stones are thrown upwards simultaneously with velocities v1 and v2. What is the meaning of this one? Ante, for example, if this is the tower, clear, ma'am? Two stones are thrown upwards only. So one stone is thrown upwards from top of the tower. So height of the tower is not given, no ma. So let height of the tower is h, right on this one. Let height of tower is h. Height of the tower, let it be h. So from this height of the tower, one stone is thrown upwards with a velocity of v1. Okay. At the same time, another stone is also thrown upwards, but from the bottom of the tower with a velocity of v2. This is the given condition. Are they the question? Clear nama? So two stones are thrown upwards, one from top and one from the bottom. And both are thrown in upwards direction only. And what are the velocities with which we are throwing them? We are throwing them with velocities of v1 and v2. Clear nama? Then if the stones meet at the top of the tower, first condition, in between bottom and top of the tower, second condition, third condition is below the tower, then you are supposed to find out the time taken in all the three conditions. Okay? So I will do case number 1, then you are supposed to do remaining cases, case number 2 and 3. Fine, ma? So, case number 1 is, so this is the tower. So one stone is thrown upwards like this, with how much velocity? With a velocity of v1. And another stone is thrown from bottom of the tower, with how much velocity, ma? With a velocity of v2. Then in the case number 1, where they are meeting? At the top of the tower. It means this stone will travel and may reach up to here. By that time, this stone would have reached up to here. Clear, no? So they are, where they are meeting? They are meeting above the tower. Above the tower only, no? And above the tower, at what distance they are meeting? That I don't know. So let us consider they are meeting somewhere at a distance of x. Okay, ma? Let us suppose they are meeting somewhere at a height of x above the tower. Are you able to understand? Okay. So therefore, what I will do, I will write one equation for stone number 1, one equation for stone number 2. So this is my stone number 1, this is my stone number 2, and I will try to find out what is the time taken for these bodies to meet if this is the height of the tower. Fine, ma? So stone number 1. So definitely this is accelerated motion only, no ma? Bodies are moving under acceleration only, no? Acceleration due to gravity only, no? So uniform motion or non-uniform motion? Non-uniform motion. So how many equations are there? 4 equations. Out of the 4 equations, which equation I can use? S is equal to ut plus half at square. Why you are using that equation only? Because question is based on height and time. Height and time present in only one equation, no? S is equal to ut plus half at square. So write that equation. So I will use the equation S is equals to ut plus half at square. Okay, ma? See, ma, selection of equation is also very important. Which equation you are selecting, your final answer depends on that, whether you get the answer or not. Pitch pulka equation le theesukone answer raavalante raadu anamata. Able to understand? You have to select the right equation always. Okay, now for stone number 1, this is stone number 1, no? For stone number 1, what is the displacement? Can you say for stone number 1 displacement is how much? X plus x or minus x?
Plus x.
Plus x. Why you are taking plus x? This is the reference, huh? Why you are not taking this one as the reference? First stone is thrown from here, no ma? So for stone number 1, this is the reference. From wherever you are throwing, that becomes the reference. Are you able to understand? So therefore, for stone number 1, this is the reference for stone number 1. Clear, ma? And this is the initial position. Finally, first stone reached up to here, no? It is above the reference or below the reference? Above the reference. By how much height? X. So plus x or minus x? Plus x. Why plus x? Because it is above the reference. Understood, Dama? So therefore, I will write, instead of S, I will write x plus x. Initial velocity? V1. Plus V1 or minus V1? Plus V1. Why plus V1? Because it is again above the reference. V1. Time taken? Time taken, I don't know. That's what I'm supposed to calculate, no? A value? Minus G. So minus a half G T square. So this is my first equation. Are you able to understand, ma?
Ten
you can place, but numericals are not given, ma. So you better write in G only. So depending on answer, 4 options low, what is your option given? According to that, you have to do the problem. Clear, no? When numericals are not given, generally he will place G to be G only. Fine? Okay. Now I will write equation for stone number 2. Stone number 2. Okay, ma? For stone number 2 also, I can use the same equation, no, ma? Again, S is equals to ut plus half a t square. Okay? Now, what is the displacement of stone number 2? H plus x. Very good. Because for stone number 2, this will become the reference, no, ma? Reference for stone number 2. Because stone number 2 is thrown from here, no? And what is the final height it is reaching? From here to here it is h, and from here to here it is x. So total height is h plus x. Okay, so h plus x. Okay, initial velocity, initial velocity v2, plus v2 or minus v2? Plus v2. Because why plus v2? Above the reference. So v2. Time taken, that is what I am supposed to calculate. So minus a half g t square. This is common, no? Sima, both of them, they are starting at same time, no? And both of them, they are meeting also after same time, no? So time intervals for stone number 1 and stone number 2 are same. Time intervals are same. So for first stone also, I am taking t only. For second stone also, I am taking t only. Because time intervals are same, no? For both of them. Both of them started at the same time. Both of them, they ended at the same time. Clear? So time interval is same. Okay. Now, by using these two equations, I am supposed to find out time. అదే కదా నాకు కావాల్సింది సో లెట్ అస్ సీ వాట్ ఐ కెన్ డూ ఓకేమా సో సిమా హియర్ ఐ హ్యావ్ ఎక్స్ ఎక్స్ ఈస్ అన్నోన్ క్వాంటిటీను ఎక్స్ వాడేమని ఇచ్చినాడు ఆ క్వశ్చన్లో ఇవ్వలేదు వీ హ్యావ్ అజ్యూమ్డ్ దట్ సో ఇన్ ద ఫైనల్ ఆన్సర్ మీ అజంప్షన్స్ ఏముండకూడదు అక్కడ ద డేటా గివెన్ ఇన్ ద క్వశ్చన్ షుడ్ బి ప్రెసెంట్ సో టేక్ దిస్ ఎక్స్ వాల్యూ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ ఇన్ దిస్ సెకండ్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఓకేమా దెర్ ఫార్ హౌ కెన్ ఐ డూ హెచ్ ప్లస్ Instead of x, what I can write? V1t minus half gt square. So V1t minus half gt square. This is equals to, now what is the remaining equation? So V2t minus half gt square. That's all, no? So minus half gt square minus half gt square will get cancelled. Clear? So h is equals to V2t minus V1t. So therefore, what is the time taken? Time taken is equals to h divided by V2 minus V1. Clear, ma? So this is my equation for time taken for both the stones to meet where? Above the top of the tower. Are you able to understand? Arthamaindha ma ela chesanu? So what we have done, just I have written one equation for stone number 1. In this equation, I have two unknown quantities, no? Time is unknown quantity, x value is also unknown quantity. If two unknown quantities are there, I require another equation, no? So I have written one more equation for stone number 2. Then I have solved both of them, very easily I got the answer. Okay, so total calculation we have done based on sign conventions. Okay, now do the case number 2 and case number 3 on the board. Case number 2, what is case number 2? We are taking two stones, one is thrown upwards, one is thrown upwards, velocity v1, velocity v2, height is h, so they will meet somewhere at the top and bottom of the towers. This is called top and bottom, no? Top of the tower, bottom of the tower. So at what height they are meeting, I don't know. So let us consider below the tower, it is meeting at a height of h. Okay, I don't know where they are meeting, no? So I am assuming they are meeting at a height of h below the top of the tower. Okay, so write one equation for stone number 1. So again, I will use s is equals to ut plus half at square. So what is the distance traveled by stone number 1 minus x? Because this is the reference for stone number 1, this is the reference for stone number 2. So it is below the reference by a distance of x. So I will write minus x. Initial velocity plus v1 minus half g t square. Clear, no? Similarly, I will write equation for stone number 2. Clear, no? Again, I will use the equation s is equal to ut plus half at square. Clear, no? Now stone number 2 has reached up to this position. So what is this total height? This height will become, total height is h, no? From h you are supposed to remove this x value, h minus x. So that will be the height reached by second stone. And this is plus h minus x or minus h minus x? Plus h minus x, because it is above the reference, no? Clear, no? Above the reference. So therefore I will write plus h minus x. Initial velocity positive minus half g t square. Clear, no? So just you take this minus x, substitute in the place of minus x. Therefore what I will get? So therefore h, instead of minus x, what I can write? Instead of minus x, I will write v1 t minus half g t square is equals to v2t minus half g t square. Minus half g t square, minus half g t square get cancelled. So h is equals to v2t minus v1t. So again I got t is equals to h divided by v2 minus v1. So this is the condition for case number 2. Fine, ma? Understood, no? Okay. So this height is the only variation in case number 2. Okay. Stone number 1, negative height, no? Minus x. But the stone number 1, it is reaching only up to this height, no? So from total height, I have to remove this much height. Then it is h minus x. And this is a positive height, no? So plus h minus x. So that is my case number 2. Okay. Similarly, try the case number 3. Case number 3, try it. So height of the tower is h, clear? So it is thrown above the reference with the velocity of v1, and this one is thrown above the reference with the velocity of v2. So where they are meeting? They are meeting below the tower, no? It means both of them, they are meeting somewhere here. Clear? And reference height is anything you can take. I will take from here. It has covered a distance of x. Yes. Okay. 1 minute. Okay, ma. So stones, they are meeting below the tower, no? So this is called below the tower. Okay. And from the below the tower, at what height? Let us assume a height of x. And but I don't know what is x value. Now I am supposed to calculate x value. Okay, ma. So again, same concept. Write one equation for stone number 1. Write one equation for stone number 2. So I will use the relation s is equals to ut plus half a t square. Now what is the displacement of stone number 1, ma? H plus x. Minus h plus x or plus h plus x? Minus h plus x, because from this reference, this is below the reference, no? So minus of h plus x. So from here to here it is h, from here to here it is x. Clear? Initial velocity? v1t minus half g t square, first equation. Then you write one equation for stone number 2. Stone number 2, s is equal to ut plus half a t square. So what is the displacement of stone number 2? Stone number 2, minus x, because it is below the reference, no? Minus x. So initial velocity, positive. So v2t minus half g t square. G is always negative. Clear number? So therefore, let us try to do this calculation. So here what I have, minus h minus x is equals to v1t minus half gt square. And here I have minus x number. Instead of this minus x, I can write v2t minus half gt square. Okay. So minus h plus, instead of minus x, v2t minus half gt square is equals to v1t minus half g t square. Half g t square, half g t square will get cancelled. So therefore, h is equals to v2t minus v1t. So therefore, t is equals to h divided by v2 minus v1. So again, I got the same answer. Clear number? So in case number 1, case number 2, as well as case number 3, I should get the same time. Then only my answer is correct. Fine? That's it. Understood the sign conventions, number? So we are doing this problem only to understand the sign conventions, ma. How we should use the sign conventions. Fine? That's it. Make a note. So let us see this problem. So what is the given data? A body is thrown vertically upwards from top of a tower. Clear, ma'am? So first of all, we will try to draw the diagram of this one. So case number 1. Clear, Nama? So this is the tower, and height of the tower, at least, is it given? Height of the tower is also not given, Nama. So let us suppose height of the tower is h. Clear? So from this height of the tower, what is case number 1? A body is thrown vertically upwards. Clear, Nama? From the top of a tower, and it reaches the ground in a time of t1. It means I am throwing a body from here. With how much velocity is it given? Velocity anna ichinada kanisam, velocity is also not given. Clear, Nama? So let us suppose we will assume velocity is u. Are you able to understand, Nama? So with this velocity, the body is thrown, then how much time it is taking to reach the ground? It is taking a time of t1. That is the given condition, Nama. Time taken is t1 for the body to reach the ground. Are you able to understand? Then for this one, I can write one equation now for this condition. Which equation I can use? So height, time, initial velocity. All of them, they are present in which equation? S is equals to ut plus half t square. First of all, is this uniform motion or accelerated motion? Accelerated motion, no, definitely, because body is traveling under the effect of gravitational force. And gravitational force will provide acceleration, number g is 9.8. Clear, no? So definitely this is accelerated motion. If it is accelerated motion, I can use which relation? I can use the relation S is equals to ut plus half a t square. This is the relation which I can use. Clear, number? S value is how much? S value? Minus h. Why minus h? Because body is thrown from here, no? So from wherever you throw the body, that becomes my reference. Clear, Nama? And from the reference, finally body has reached downwards, Nama. So negative height. Negative height means instead of s, I have to write minus h. Clear? Initial velocity? U. Plus u or minus u? Plus u. Why plus u? Because it is above the reference. Clear, Nama? So plus u. Time taken? T1. A instead of A? Minus g, a should be always negative, no? So minus half g t1 square. So this is my first equation. Is it clear? Now let us see what he is asking case number 2. Okay, ma? What is case number 2? If it is thrown vertically downwards with the same speed, it reaches the ground in a time of t2. Clear, Nama? It means again I am taking the same tower. Height of the tower remains to be h only. Clear, Nama? But in second condition, how I am throwing the stone? I am throwing the stone downwards. With how much velocity? With same velocity. Here I have assumed initial velocity is u, Nama. So here also initial velocity is u only. But I am throwing in which direction? I am throwing in downwards direction with the same initial velocity of u. Okay. Now in this condition also, time taken is how much he gave? Time taken is t2. So here time taken is t2. So which equation I can use again? Again, same equation. S is equals to ut plus t2. half a t square. Are you able to understand? Now instead of s, minus h, again body is thrown from here, no ma? So this becomes my reference. Clear, no? So from the reference, body has come downwards, final. So negative height, so minus h. Initial velocity? Minus u. Why I am taking initial velocity minus u? Because it is thrown downwards, no? So from the reference, body is thrown downwards, so negative height. So minus u t, time taken? T2. And a is always minus g, no ma? So minus half g t2 square. So this is my second equation. Are you able to understand? Okay. Got it. Sim. So case number 2. Up to here it is fine, no ma? Now let us see case number 3. Then what he is saying, if it is allowed to fall freely, then find time taken to reach the ground. So in initial condition, we are throwing the body upwards. Second condition, we are throwing the body downwards. In third condition, we are releasing the body. Releasing means what? Initial velocity is 0. That is called releasing norma. So case number 3. So if this is the tower, clear ma? So from this tower of height h, we are releasing the body. Releasing means what? Releasing means initial velocity is 0. We are just releasing the body. We are not throwing it downwards. Clear? Then for this condition, what is the equation? Again, I can use the same relation. S is equals to ut plus half at square. Clear, Nama? So here time taken is t1, here time taken is t2, and here time taken, let it be t or t3, anything you can assume. So again, S value? Minus h. Initial velocity? 0, because it is a freely falling body. So minus half g t square. Clear, Nama? So here time taken, I am taking to be t. So therefore, minus and minus, if you get cancelled, then h is equals to half g t square. So this is the equation which I got. So let it be first equation, second equation, third equation, anything. Are you able to understand? Okay. So now, Sima, here how many unknown quantities are there? Two unknown quantities. Height I don't know. Time also I don't know. Clear? What I am supposed to calculate? Time. But height is not there. It means from these two equations, I am supposed to calculate height. So calculate height, substitute here, then I will get the required equation. That is the method of solving, no? Clear, Nama? Okay. Now, again, if you take these equations 1 and 2, first equation and second equation, clear, Nama? So here, I have two unknown quantities once again. Height is one unknown quantity, initial velocity is also one unknown quantity. Okay, bah? So you can do one thing. You can calculate a u value from here, take this u value, substitute here, then you will get height. Okay, ma? Or you can do one more thing. So here also minus h, here also minus h, I have, no? Just equate both of them. From that also you can get initial velocity, no? Take that initial velocity and again substitute in any one of the equations, you can get height. Take that height, substitute here, you will get the required equation. Different methods of solving the same problem. Clear, ma? So the method which I will adopt is, I have minus h and minus h, no? I will equate both of them. So if I equate both of them, let us see what we will get. Okay, so 1 is equal to 2. Okay, so ut1 minus half g t1 square is equals to minus ut2 minus half g t2 square. Here I have plus u, here I have minus u, take on the both side. So u, if you take common, then it will become t1 plus t2. So here I have minus half g t1 square, take to the other side, it will become half g t1 square, and here already I have minus half g t2 square. Clear, Nama? So therefore, initial velocity is equals to half g, if I take common, then I am left with the t1 square minus t2 square divided by, and previously here I have t1 plus t2, Nama, so write t1 plus t2. I got equation up to here, no? So just this half g you have forgot. It occurred much better. Okay. So now this is of the form of a square minus b square, Nama? A square minus b square can be written as a plus b into a minus b. So therefore, how I can write? I can write t1 plus t2 multiplied by t1 minus t2 divided by t1 plus t2 multiplied by half g. Clear? No? So t1 plus t2, t1 plus t2 get cancelled. So therefore, what is the equation of u I got? Initial velocity, how much I got, ma? So therefore, initial velocity is equals to half g into t1 minus t2. So this is the equation for initial velocity. Now take this initial velocity, substitute in any one of the equation, then you will get height also, no? You will get height. In which equation I will substitute? You can substitute anyone, either in first equation or second equation. I will substitute in second equation. Okay, ma? What is the second equation? Minus h is equals to minus u t2 minus half g t2 square. Clear, ma? So therefore, every minus I can make it as plus, no, ma? Plus, plus and plus. So h is equals to initial velocity is half g into t1 minus t2. Here already I have t2 minus plus, no, plus half g t2 square. So therefore h is equals to half g t1 t2 minus half g t2 square plus half g t2 square. So plus half g t2 square minus half g t2 square will get cancelled. So therefore what is the final answer I got? H is equals to half g t1 t2. So this is the equation of height of the tower. Clear, no? So once I calculate height of the tower, now you can substitute here, then you will get t, no? And t is my required answer. Time taken for the stone to reach the ground when it is a freely falling body. Understood, no? So therefore substitute, so let it be my equation number 3, let it be my equation number 4. Then what I will do? Substitute 4 in 3. Clear, no? So what is h? Instead of h I can write half g t1 t2 is equals to half g t square. So half g get cancelled. So t is equals to root of t1 t2. So this is my required answer. That's it. Very simple. Clear, ma? So make a note of question, ma. So a body is projected upwards with the velocity of u from the ground. Okay, ma? So it passes through a certain point above the ground after a time of t1. If the time after which body passes through the same point, find the time after which body passes through the same point during the return journey. What is the meaning of this one? Let us try to understand. Okay. See, consider this is ground. A body is thrown upwards with an initial velocity u. This is the data which is given, no? And here there is one more data which is given. So final answer should be in terms of given data only. Clear? So first of all, I am throwing a body. So if I throw this body like this, then first of all it will reach to a maximum height, then it will return back, no? This is what will happen, no? First it reaches to a certain point, then it starts returning backwards with an increasing velocity. Clear, no? So when it is moving upwards, consider he is reaching some point here. So to reach this point, how much time it is taken? Time taken is t1. Clear, Nama? And how much initial velocity he has thrown? He has thrown with an initial velocity of u1. Now in the return journey, again he will reach the same position once again, Nama? Same position, again he will reach the same point in the return journey also. And for that one, what is the time taken? For that one, the time taken, let it be t2. So that means time taken to travel from here and to reach up to here. So that time taken, let it be t2. So what I am supposed to find out here, t2 value only I am supposed to calculate. Are you able to understand? So when it is moving upwards, time taken is t1. And time taken to travel from here again to reach the same point, that total time taken is t2. So I am supposed to find out t2 value in terms of this given values. Okay. So here I have two conditions, Nama. To travel from here to here, it is one condition. And to travel from here to here, it is second condition. Are you able to understand? So let us write equation for case number 1. Okay, Ma? Case number 1 is what? Starting from the ground, reaching up to here. Are you able to understand? So which equation I will use? You can use either s is equals to ut plus half at square, or you can use v is equals to u plus at. Any equation you can use. Clear, Nama? I will use the equation v is equals to u plus at. Okay, Ma? So when body reaches up to here, at this point it will be having certain final velocity v, Nama? When it reaches here, it will be having some final velocity v, which is definitely less than initial velocity. When body is moving upwards, velocity increases or decreases? Pike velte velocity perugutunda tagutunda? Velocity decreases, Nama? So final velocity will be definitely less than initial velocity, but it is moving upwards, no? So this velocity, shall I take positive or negative? Positive, because body is thrown from here, no? This is my reference. So when compared to the reference, body is moving in upwards direction, no? So final velocity will be plus v. Okay. Initial velocity? Initial velocity u, plus u or minus u? Plus u. Why plus u? Because it is above the reference. Plus u. Acceleration? Minus g. G value? G value we will find out later. So minus g. Time taken? T1. Clear, Nama? So therefore, v is equals to u minus g t1. So this is my first equation. That's all, Nama? Next, I will write case number 2. What is case number 2? Case number 2 is, so body has started from here, it has reached the maximum height, and in the return journey, again it reached the same position. That is called second case, no? Now here also I will use which equation again, I will use V is equals to U plus AD. Okay, ma? Now can you say what is the final velocity? Here final velocity is V, no? Now when body has reached the maximum height and when it is returning back, here velocity will be how much? Here also the magnitude of velocity will be V only. Okay, ma? At any point if you take, when body is moving upwards or downwards, velocity remains to be same. That is one point which you should remember in kinematics. Are you able to understand, ma? So if you take any position, for example, if you take this position. So here when it is moving upwards, here if velocity is 10 meter per second, when it is coming downwards, again velocity here will be 10 meter per second. What is the reason? Because with what velocity body has started moving upwards, with same velocity again it should touch the ground also, no? So therefore at any instant, whether it is moving upwards or downwards, velocity remains to be same. Clear, ma? Okay. Now can you say V value is how much here? Minus V, very good. Why minus V? Because when compared to the reference, body is coming downwards, no? So then according to the sign convention, velocity is in downwards direction. So I have to write minus. Clear, no? Initial velocity plus U, because initial velocity is in upward direction. Acceleration minus G, time taken T2. Clear, no? Now here how many unknown quantities are there? V is the unknown quantity. Here how many unknown quantities are there? V and T2, two unknown quantities are there. Clear, no? And from here I can substitute V value, no? So therefore minus of, instead of V what I can write? U minus G T1 I can write, no? Instead of V what I can write? U minus G T1 is equal to, now you write the remaining equation, U minus G T2. Clear, no? So therefore minus U plus G T1 is equals to U minus G T2. Clear, ma? So therefore I want T2 only, no? So what I will do, so GT2 is equals to 2U minus GT1. So therefore T is equals to 2U minus GT1 divided by G. Clear, ma? So therefore T2 is equals to 2U by G minus T1. So this is my equation in which the body comes to the same position in the return journey. Clear, ma? That's it. Okay. From a point A, 80 meters above the ground, a particle is projected vertically upwards with a velocity of 29.4 meters per second. 5 seconds later, it means after 5 seconds, another particle is dropped from point B. Okay, ma? And where is this point B? Point B is 34.3 meters below point A. Clear? So determine when and where the two stones will overtake each other. That is the question. Clear, ma? So let us try to understand this one. For example, consider this is the height of the tower. Let us consider a tower is present. So what is its initial height? The height of the tower is 80 meters. H is equal to 80 meter. So from here, a stone is thrown vertically upwards. With how much velocity? With an initial velocity of 29.4 meter per second. Clear, number? So it is thrown like this. Then after 5 seconds, from this position, we are dropping, another particle is dropped from point B. So this is point A, ma, and this one is point B. So from here a particle is dropped. Dropped means what? Dropped means initial velocity is 0 meter per second. Okay, ma? And where is this point B? This point B is present at a height of or below, how much distance? 34.3 meters below point A. That is the given question. Clear, no? So therefore, this body is traveling like, so it will travel like this and it starts returning back, no? Clear, no? And by that time, after 5 seconds, this body is also released. So this body goes and meets with this particle which is thrown from point A. So this is the particle thrown from point A and this is the particle released from point B. So let us assume they are meeting somewhere here. Okay, ma? So at what height they are meeting and at what time they will meet, that I am supposed to calculate. That is the question. Question arthamainda? Now come on, say how can I do this calculation? Clear na? So therefore, first of all, I will write two bodies are there, Nama. So you are supposed to write two equations. So first I will write for stone number one. Stone number one. Which equation I have to use? Question is based on heights and times only, no? Height and time are present in which equation? They are present in the equation S is equal to ut plus half at squared, this equation. Clear, Nama? Then what is the final height reached by first stone? First stone has reached totally how much height? So from point B, let us consider this height is h. This is an unknown quantity, no? Let us consider this height is h. Then what is the height reached by, or what is the displacement of first stone? This is the first stone. First stone displacement is how much? చెప్పండి ఐదు చెప్పలేకపోతే ఇంకెందుకు మీరు 18 వాట్ ఈస్ ద హైట్ ఆఫ్ ఫస్ట్ స్టోన్ సో ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ హైట్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ నోనా సో దేర్ ఫోర్ దిస్ హైట్ ఆల్రెడీ ఐ నోను వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ హైట్ 34.3 ప్లస్ హెచ్ ఐ కెన్ కాల్ ఇట్ సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద రెఫరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ స్టోన్ నంబర్ వన్ నో వాట్ ఈస్ మెంట్ బై రెఫరెన్స్ సో ఫ్రమ్ వేర్ ఎవర్ స్టోన్ ఈస్ స్టోన్ థ్రోన్ దట్ ఈస్ మై రెఫరెన్స్ So from here, finally stone 1 has reached up to here. So what is the total height? 34.3 plus h. And 34.3 plus h, total plus value or minus value? Minus value, because this is negative height, no?
ఏం ఆలోచిస్తున్నారు మీరు? ఇట్లయితే మీ తల్లిదండ్రులు ముంచేస్తారు మీరు. ఇంత డల్లుకుంటే ఎట్లా? చాలా ఫాస్ట్గా ఉండాలి. అర్థమవుతుందా? ఏముంది అక్కడ? ఆల్రెడీ డిస్కస్ చేసుకున్న పాయింట్సే కదా. క్లియర్? భారతదేశంలో ఎడ్యుకేషన్ తప్ప ఏది పనికిరాదు ఇంకా. అర్థమవుతుందా? పొలాలుంటే వ్యవసాయం చేసుకుందామంటే వర్షం ఎప్పుడు వస్తుందో దేవునికే తెలుసు అన్నమాట. నాకు కూడా ఉంటాయి 10 ఎకరాలు 15 ఎకరాలు పొలాలు ఉన్నాయి, ఏం లాభం లేదు చేసుకోవాలి. అర్థమవుతుందా? ఎడ్యుకేషన్ తప్ప భారతదేశంలో వేరే ఆప్షన్ లేదు. మీరు అమెరికాకు పోయినారనుకోండి, పెట్రోల్ పంపులో పనిచేసుకున్నా మీకు హ్యాపీగా మీరు లగ్జరీ కార్లో తిరగచ్చు, అంత ఇన్కమ్ వస్తుంది అమెరికాలో. పెట్రోల్ బంకులోనే మీరు పనిచేసేది, కానీ మీరు బీఎండబ్ల్యూ కార్ని మెయింటైన్ చేయొచ్చు అక్కడ. అర్థమవుతుంది కదా? ఇక్కడ అట్లా కాదు, హియర్ సిచ్యువేషన్ ఈస్ కంప్లీట్లీ డిఫరెంట్. ఓకే, ఏదన్నా ఇండస్ట్రీస్ ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ చేద్దాము, ఏదో పెద్ద సాధిద్దామని ఇక్కడ ఏమీ సాధ్యం కావద్దు. చదువు తప్ప వేరే ఆప్షనే లేదు భారతదేశం. ఓకే, బిజినెస్లో అవన్నీ ఉన్నాయి, సక్సెస్ అవుతాయి ఫెయిల్ అవుతాయి అదేమీ తెలుసు అన్నమాట. ఒక చిన్న ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్తాను చూడండి. మీరు స్కూల్ నుంచి ఇంటి నుంచి మన ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్కి వచ్చే దారి ఉంటుంది కదా, ఆ దారిలో ఒకరోజు మీరు వచ్చేటప్పుడు మొత్తం షాప్స్ అన్నీ మీరు కౌంట్ చేసుకోండి, అంటే ఏ చోట ఏ షాప్ ఉందో. ఒక సంవత్సరం తర్వాత చూడండి, ఒక షాప్ కూడా అక్కడ ఉండదు, వేరే షాప్ వచ్చిట్ట దాని ప్లేస్లో. ఎందుకంటే ఫెయిల్యూర్, సక్సెస్ ఫెయిల్ అవుతుంది. ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ పెడతారు 100 బిజినెస్లు పెడితే ఒకటి సక్సెస్ అవుతుంది, అంటే 99 లేచిపోతాయి. అర్థమవుతుంది కదా? సో భారతదేశంలో ఎడ్యుకేషన్ తప్ప వేరే ఆప్షనే లేదు. కాంపిటీషన్ అలా ఉంది, 135 కోట్లు జనాభా. అర్థమవుతుంది కదా? బ్రెయిన్ మీద విపరీతమైన ప్రెషర్ పెట్టి చాలా కేర్ఫుల్గా ఒక్కొక్క పాయింట్ని అల్లుకుంటూ చదువుకోవాలి. ఓకే, చిన్న పాయింట్స్ చెప్పలేకపోతే ఎట్లా మీరు చెప్పండి? సో దేర్ ఫోర్ స్టోన్ వన్, దిస్ ఈస్ ద రిఫరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ స్టోన్ నెంబర్ వన్ నోమా. ఫైనలీ స్టోన్ నెంబర్ వన్ హ్యాస్ రీచ్డ్ అప్ టు హియర్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ద టోటల్ హైట్? 34.3 ప్లస్ హెచ్. అండ్ దిస్ ఈస్ మై అజ్యూమ్డ్ హైట్. అండ్ ఇన్ ద ఫైనల్ ఆన్సర్ దిస్ షుడ్ నాట్ కమ్, అంతే కదా, అజ్యూమ్డ్ వాల్యూ షుడ్ నాట్ బి ప్రెసెంట్. అండ్ దిస్ ఈస్ నెగటివ్ హైట్ నోమా, వెన్ కంపేర్డ్ టు ద రిఫరెన్స్ బాడీస్ ఆర్ కమింగ్ డౌన్వర్డ్స్ నో. సో దేర్ ఫోర్ ఐ విల్ రైట్ మైనస్ ఆఫ్ 34.3 ప్లస్ హెచ్. క్లియర్ నో? సో దిస్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఇనీషియల్ వెలాసిటీ ఆఫ్ స్టోన్ నెంబర్ వన్? 29.4 ప్లస్ 29 ఆర్ మైనస్ 29? ప్లస్ 29, బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ థ్రోన్ అబౌవ్ ద రిఫరెన్స్ నో. సో 29.4 మల్టిప్లైడ్ బై, అండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద టైమ్ టేకన్? టైమ్ టేకన్ ఓన్లీ ఐఎమ్ సపోజ్ టు క్యాల్కులేట్ నమ్మా. సో టి, సో మైనస్ హాఫ్ జీ టి స్క్వేర్. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ మై ఫస్ట్ ఈక్వేషన్, దట్స్ ఆల్ నో. ఏ ఈస్ ఆల్వేస్ మైనస్ జీ, సో మైనస్ హాఫ్ జీ టి స్క్వేర్. ఓకే, దెన్ స్టోన్ నంబర్ టూ. స్టోన్ నంబర్ టూ, సో స్టోన్ నంబర్ టూ ఈస్ రిలీజ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ బట్ ఈస్ రిలీజ్డ్ ఆఫ్టర్ 5 సెకండ్స్. సో ఇట్ మీన్స్ ఇఫ్ టైమ్ టేకన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ స్టోన్ ఈస్ 8 సెకండ్స్, టైమ్ టేకన్ బై దిస్ స్టోన్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ 3 సెకండ్స్, బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ థ్రోన్ ఆఫ్టర్ హౌ మచ్ టైమ్? ఇట్ ఈస్ థ్రోన్ ఆఫ్టర్ 5 సెకండ్స్. క్లియర్ నో? సో దేర్ ఫర్ అగైన్ ఐ కెన్ యూస్ ద సేమ్ రిలేషన్, అగైన్ ఐ విల్ యూస్ ఎస్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు యూటీ ప్లస్ హాఫ్ ఎటీ స్క్వేర్. క్లియర్ నమ్మా? సో వాట్ ఈస్ ద హైట్ రీచ్డ్ బై సెకండ్ స్టోన్?
minus h. Only h only it has traveled, no? Minus h. Initial velocity? Zero, because it is a freely falling body, dropped, freely falling body. So minus a half g. And what is the time taken? Time taken is, if this time is t, time taken by second stone will be t minus 5 whole square. Are you able to understand ma? So therefore, this is my second equation. Okay. So from both this first equation and second equation, you are supposed to find out, what you are supposed to find out ma? Time taken as well as this h value. Okay. So you can do one thing, Noma, you can take this h value and you can substitute here, then total equation you will get in terms of time only, no? So solve that equation, you will get a time. Once you get a time, take that time, substitute in either first equation or second equation, you will get height also. అంత దారుణమైన ఆన్సర్ ఎంత? జీ వాల్యూ హౌ మచ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టేకన్? 8 seconds వస్తుంది ఆన్సర్. 8 షుడ్ బి ద ఆన్సర్. నేను చెప్పిన తర్వాత వచ్చిందా ముందే వచ్చిందా? ఓకేనా? సో ఇఫ్ యూ సింప్లిఫై దిస్ క్యాల్కులేషన్ యూ షుడ్ గెట్ టైమ్ టేకన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 8 seconds. So this is my answer for first question. Okay, so it means the both the stones, they will meet after how much time? They will meet after a time of 8 seconds. Now I have second equation also, height also I am supposed to calculate them where they will meet. So I will use this relation. So minus minus will get cancelled. I will get h is equals to half g into, instead of t I can write 8 minus 5 whole square. So h is equals to half into 9.8 into 3 square. Clear nama? So it is 4.9 into 9. Okay ma? So 9 9s are 81. 9 4s are 4.9 into 9. 9 5s are 9 5s are 45. From 45, so it is 44.1 meters. That is our answer. Clear number? It means below the tower. Below the tower only, no, this height we have taken. So below the tower where the two stones are meeting at a height of 44.1 meters. Clear number? And from the top of the tower, height of the tower 80, no? 80 plus 44.1 meter. If you take from the top of the tower, this is the top of the tower, Noma. So stones are meeting somewhere here. This height we have calculated, 44.1. So if you ask questions from the top, then this is 80 meters, no? So 80 plus 44.1, that is our